Today we'll study a very simple topic which always guarantees marks in JEE Mains, and the topic is Mathematical Reasoning. It is our ability to reason and the intellect that we possess which has made us superior to all other beings on this planet. So in this chapter we'll study different aspects of Mathematical Reasoning. Now Mathematical Reasoning, it starts with something called as Mathematical Statement. Any statement which can be answered as certain true or a certain false, then we say it is mathematical statement or mathematically acceptable statement. Say for example, suppose I say a statement is 2 plus 2 equals 5. Now we know that 2 plus 2 is not equal to 5 and this is certainly false. So that means this statement is a mathematically acceptable statement. I'll consider another one. Square of an odd number is an odd number. So we'll take a square of a number, 2n plus 1 whole square. So we know that it is 4n square plus 4n plus 1. So this is even, plus 1 is odd. So this is always odd. So this statement is always true. So we can say this statement is also a mathematically acceptable statement. And now let us consider this statement. Today is Sunday. Now this statement, it can be true with a probability of 1 by 7 and it can be false with a probability of 6 by 7. So at times this statement will be true and other times this statement will be false. So that means this statement is not a mathematical statement or mathematically acceptable statement. Now consider another one, which is Rahul Dravid is India's best ever test player. Now this statement, it is true for me, but it may not be true for someone who is a Sunil Gavaskar's fan or other cricketer's fan, right? So this again is not a statement. So any statement which can be answered with a definite true or a definite false, then we say it is a mathematically acceptable statement. Otherwise, it is not a mathematically acceptable statement. And we denote statements with either capital letters, suppose A, B, or at times we'll also denote them with small letters, maybe A, B, X, Y. So any mathematically acceptable statement can have a truth value. Either it can be true or it can be false. The statements that we have studied are simple statements. In mathematical reasoning, there is a provision where we can group or combine several statements to form a new statement. And we do that by using something called as connectives. So connectives combine two or more statements to form more complicated or more profound statements called as compound statements. So in order to study compound statements, let us study connectives. And the first connective that we'll study is the end connective or simply conjunction. Now this connective is represented by this upward arrow. So if I say there are two statements, statement A and statement B, suppose statement A is Ram is good, Ram is honest, then if I'll say A and B, it simply means Ram is good and Ram is honest. Now one thing that we'll need to study with every connective is its truth table. So we'll study truth table for conjunction. So suppose we have two statements A and B. Now any statement can have two possible values, either true or false. So that means together A and B will have four possibilities. Either both of them they are true, 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 false, false, true, and false, false. And here we'll write the result of A conjunction B or A and B. A compound statement A and B will be true if and only if A is true as well as B is true. So that means if A is true and B is true, then this statement is true. If A is true but B is false, the statement is false. If A is false, B is true, again it is false. And if both the statements are false, then also it is false. So this is truth table for end. Another way to interpret or to understand end connective is using logical circuits. So suppose we have this circuit. Suppose this is light bulb and then it is connected to some battery and we have two switches. switch A and B. So when is this light bulb going to glow? So it is going to glow only when A is closed and B is closed. So we'll say the switches, if they are closed, then the value is true. And if the switch is open, then the value is false. So the only way this light bulb is going to glow is when both the switches, they are closed. So that means when both the statements, they are true, A and B will be true. And for all other cases, this value will be simply false. Now suppose consider a statement P, which is 2 is less than 3, and statement Q is every rectangle is a square. So what about truth value of P and Q? So P and Q simply means 2 is less than 3 and every rectangle is a square. So now we know that 2 is less than 3 is true, but every rectangle is not a square. So this statement is simply false. So when A is true and B is false, the truth value of P and Q is simply false. Now the second connector that we'll study in reasoning is logical or simply disjunction. So when I say or, we write it as downward arrow. So this is A or B. So statement A or statement B. Now say for example, A is 2 plus 2 equals 4 and B is 3 is greater than 4. So if I'll say A or B, it simply means 2 plus 2 is equal to 4 or 3 is greater than 4. So we'll look at truth table of disjunction. So suppose this is A, this is B, and this is A or B. Now again, A and B, they can have four values: true, 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 false, false, true, and false, false. Now this compound statement A or B is true when either A or B is true. So when at least one of them is true, then A or B will be true. So if A and B, they're both true, the statement is true. A is true, B is false. Then again, it is true. A is false, B is true. Then again, it is true. Now when A is false and B is false, so this statement is false. So the only case where the statement A or B will be false when both statement A and statement B, they're false. Now let us consider truth value of this given statement. Now 2 plus 2 equals 4. This is true. And 3 is greater than 4. This is false. So true or false is simply true. So at least one of them, it should be true. Now we can also understand this or disjunction through simple logical circuit. So suppose again we have this light bulb, we have this battery, and then we have two switches. Now these two switches, they are connected in parallel. This is switch A and this is switch B. So now in this case, the bulb will glow when either A is closed or B is closed or both of them, they are closed. The only case where this bulb will not glow is when both the switches, they are open. So this is logically equivalent circuit for A or B or A disjunction B. Now the third connector that we'll study in mathematical reasoning is negation of a statement. So suppose we have any statement A, and which is 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. Now if we have to write negation of the statement, then we express negation of a statement with this tilde sign. So this is not A. And not A simply is, if A is 2 plus 2 equals 4, then not A is 2 plus 2 is not equal to 4. If we look at truth table for negation, so that means if we have this A, then we have to write truth values for not A. So this A can have only two values. Either it can be true or it can be false. If A is true, then not A is false. And if A is false, then not A is true. So this is negation of a statement. So there have been many questions in JE Mains on negation of a statement. Generally, negation of a statement involves compound statement. So we'll come back to negation of a statement once we are done with all the connectives and all the properties. At this point of time, there is just one small thing that we need to keep in mind. So when we are concerned with negation of a statement, and that is, suppose we have any statement, which is, suppose statement is X, and it is everyone in India speaks English. So if we are going to write its negation as everyone in India does not speak English, so in that case, this negation is completely wrong. Why is it wrong? when the statement claims that everyone speaks English, right? So in order to find a negation of the statement, all I need to do is I'll just need to present a person who doesn't speak English. So for everyone, its negation is at least one. So if I have to write negation of the statement, then negation of the statement is there is at least one person in India which doesn't speak English. So when we have this everyone, then its negation is at least one. And if we have the statement as at least one, then its negation is everyone or all. Now say for example, now suppose the statement is there exists a natural number which is not greater than zero. What is the negation of this statement? Negation of this statement simply will be every natural number is greater than zero. So after these three connectors, disjunction, conjunction and negation, we'll study implication. So implication simply means if there are two statements such that if A, then B, then we write it as A implies B. So we use this arrow sign. So this sign represents if A, then B. Validity of statement A implies validity of statement B. So in case of A implies B, the most important thing is to write its truth table. So we'll write its truth table. So this is A, B, and this is A implies B. Now this is true, 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 false, false, true, and false, false. Now if A is true and B is true, so if A implies B, then whenever A is true, B has to be true. So this is true. Now if A is true but B is false, then A implies B is false. Now the condition when A is false, so in that case, this implication doesn't hold, right? So this implication only makes sense if A is true. So if A is false, then in both the cases, A implies B, we take it as true. So if we have A implies B, then the only case where A implies B will be false when A is true but B is false. Now this A implies B, it is logically equivalent to not A or B. So two statements, they are logically equivalent if they have same truth values. So what we'll do is we'll look for truth values of not A or B. So in the same table, I'll extend two more columns. So I'll write not A. So if A is true, not A is false. So this is false, false, true, true. Now we'll write not A or B. So we have this OR connector here. So not A or B will be true when at least one of not A or B is true. So here it is B is true, so it'll be true. B is false, not A is false, so it is false. B is true, A is true, it is true. B is false, not A is true, then it is true. So we look at truth values of A implies B and not A or B, then both these truth values, they are same. So we say that A implies B is logically equivalent to not A or B. So whenever we'll be solving questions on A implies B, then at times I'll replace A implies B with not A or B. This A implies B is also called as conditional statement. That is, if A, then B. If A is true, then B must be true. So we also call it as conditional statement. Now we'll come to biconditional statement, which is if and only if. We say A if and only if B. So it simply means A implies B and B implies A. So when we have two statements such that if A then B and if B then A, then we say it is a biconditional statement, and which is represented by this double arrow, and it means if and only if. Now we'll write truth table for A if and only if B. So this is A, this is B, and this is A if and only if B. So again we have values true, 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 false, false, true, and false, false. Now if A is true and B is true, then A, if and only if B, it'll be true. If A is false and B is false, then also it'll be true. But if one of them is true and the other one is false, then the result will be simply false. So this biconditional statement will be true only when either both the statements are true or when both the statements are false. Now we'll also prove this logical equivalence, which is A implies B and B implies A. So I'll write A implies B and B implies A, and then I'll take the conjunction. Now what's A implies B? True, 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 false, false, and then true, true. What is B implies A? B is true, A is true, then it is true. B is false, simply it is true. B is true, A is false, then it is false, and then false, then it will be true. Now if we'll take this end, true and true, it is true. False, true, false, false, true, false, true, true is true. So if we look at the two truth values, then the two tables, they are same. So that means A, if and only if B, is equivalent to A implies B and B implies A. Now we'll look at converse of A implies B. Suppose we have this statement, which is if A, then B, then converse of this if A, then B is if B, then A. Now say for example, so suppose we have this statement, which is if A, then B, and suppose we have to write converse of this statement. So what is the converse of this statement? Converse of this statement will be B implies A, that is if B, then A. So that means if X square is odd, then X is odd. So that is the converse of this given statement. Another thing that we'll study in implication is contrapositive statement. So if the statement is A implies B, then contrapositive is not B implies not A. So suppose we have this statement A implies B as if X is odd, then X square is odd. If I have to write its contrapositive statement, all I need to do is I'll simply need to write not B. So that is if X square is not odd, then not A. X is not odd. So this is how we write contrapositive statement. Now here we'll also look at truth values of contrapositive statement. So we look at truth values of contrapositive statement. Suppose this is A, B. I'll write A implies B, and then I'll write not B, not A, and I'll write not B implies not A. So I'll write the truth values. So this is true, 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 false, false, true, false, false. Now what is not B? So this is true, false, true, false. Now it'll be false, true, and A is true, true, false, false, not A is false, false, true, and true. What is A implies B? A implies B will be false only when A is true and B is false. So this is false and all the other three is true. And in the same way, for not B implies not A, so it will be only false when this is true and this is false. So this is false and all other cases will be true. So if we look at truth values, so for both of them, the truth table is same, or the truth values, they are same. So that means A implies B is logically equivalent to its contrapositive statement, and that is not B implies not A. With converse and contrapositive, we'll also study inverse of a statement. Now, if we have any conditional statement, which is A implies B, that is if A then B, then inverse for this statement will be simply not A implies not B. Say for example, suppose we have this statement, which is if X is odd, then X square is odd. So this is A implies B, then inverse of this statement simply will be not A implies not B, which is if X is not odd, then X square is not odd. So that is the inverse of this statement. Now there are two more words that we generally come across when we study mautomatical reasoning, and that is tautology and contradiction. If a mautomatical statement is always true, then we'll say it is a tautology. And if a mautomatical statement is always false, then we say it is a contradiction. Now, there is another term which is used in mathematical reasoning, and that is fallacy. I've seen many teachers and textbooks interchanging contradiction and fallacy, assuming them to be same. There is a subtle difference between contradiction and fallacy. Contradiction is when the truth value is false for all the inputs. Now, fallacy is obviously not contradiction, but fallacy is when we use incorrect proposition to reach the conclusion. So you may have seen the proofs where people prove 1 is equal to 2. There is at least one invalid proposition in all such proofs. So fallacy is a condition which is reached when using invalid premises or invalid propositions, we reach wrong conclusion. So that's fallacy, which is different from contradiction. So let us take up an example. Say, for example, we have this statement, which is P implies Q implies P. So I need to find out whether this statement is a tautology or a contradiction or neither of them. So I'll write truth table. So this is P, this is Q. I'll write Q implies P, and then I'll write P implies Q implies P. Now truth value is true, 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 false, false, true, and false, false. Now what is Q implies P? So Q implies P, it'll be false only when Q is true and P is false. So this is false, and all of the cases will be true. Now we'll find P implies Q implies P. So P is true and Q implies P is true. So then it's true. Now true, true, again true, false, false, true, then false, again it's true. So this statement is true for all the values of P and Q. So that means this statement P implies Q implies P is a tautology, and this value is always true. Now another statement is P and not Q and not P and Q. Now again we write P, Q, not P, not Q. We'll write P and not Q, not P and Q, and then we'll write P and not Q and not P and Q. So we'll again make this truth table. So this is true, 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 false, false, true, and then false, false. Now not P will be false, false, true, true. Not Q is false, true, false, true. Now first we need to write P and not Q. So P and not Q. True, false, false, true, 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 false, 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 true, false. Now not P and Q. So not P and Q. So true, false is false, false, false is false, true, true is true, and then false, true is again false. Now we need to take conjunction of these two. So false, false is false, true, false is false, false, true is false, and false, false is false. So this statement is always false. So when this statement is always false, that means this statement is a contradiction. Now in some books, even in J-Mean's exam, they have given it as a fallacy. So this statement is not a fallacy, but this statement is a contradiction. Now question number 43, again it's a biconditional statement. Now it says not of P if and only if not Q is equivalent to P if and only if Q. And second statement is this first expression is a tautology. So again I'll write P Q not Q and then P biconditional Q P biconditional not Q and negation of P biconditional not Q. So this is true, 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 false, false, true, and false, false. Not Q will be false, true, false, and true. Now P biconditional Q, so it'll be true when both of them they are true or both of them they are false. In all other cases it'll be simply false. Now what about P biconditional not Q? P biconditional not Q, true, false, false, true, 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 false, false, true, false, true, false. And if I take negation of that, I'll get true, false, false, and true. So this statement, it is not a tautology. So that means statement two is incorrect. And the first statement is this expression is equivalent to P if and only if Q. So their truth values are same. So that means statement one is correct. So option is statement one is true and statement two is false, which is your option number B. Now, generally, there are two kinds of problem in mathematical reasoning. Now, one problem, they are like proving statements. So we prove them either using truth table or we prove them using algebra of statements.
So we have already studied how to prove them using truth table. So now we'll prove them using algebra of statements. So there are certain laws that we need to study before we can embark on proving statements using algebra. Now the first property is called as idempotent law. And idempotent law simply is P or P is equivalent to P and P and P is also P. Second is commutative law. And the commutative law is both, which is P and Q is same as Q and P, and disjunction also P or Q is equivalent to Q or P. Third one is associative law, and associative law says P and Q and R is same as P and Q, and then and R in the same way P or Q or R is same as P or Q or R. So that means both disjunction and conjunction follow associative laws. Now the fourth one is distributive law. If we have P or Q and R, then it is logically equivalent to, so P or Q, so I'll take this OR with Q and I'll also take this OR with R, and P or R. In the same way, suppose I have P and Q or R, then we can write P and Q or P and R. So there'll be examples where we'll be using these distributive law. Now the fifth one is De Morgan's law. And De Morgan's law again here is very important for negation and also for proving the results. And the first one is not P and Q is equivalent to not P or not Q. So here the connective changes. And the same way, suppose I have not P or Q, then not P or Q is equivalent to not P and not Q. So this is called as De Morgan's law. Now the sixth one is identity laws. Now identity laws says P and true. P and true, it'll be true when P is true and it'll be false when P is false. So that means P and true is simply P. And if I have to write P or true, now we know that A or B is true when at least one of A or B is true. So now here we have this second statement always true. So that means this is always true. So P or true is a tautology. Now the third one is P and false. So A and B, it is always true when both A and B, they are true. So here we have the second statement, which is always false, which is a contradiction. So that means P and false will always be false. And the fourth one is P or false. Now P or false will be false when P is false and will be true when P is true. So that means P or false is equal to P or is equivalent to P. Now the seventh law is complement law. And the complement law is P and not P. Now we know that if P is true, then not P is false. And if P is false, then not P is true. So that means P and not P will always be a contradiction. So P and not P, it will always be false. And what about P or not P? So for P or not P, at least one of them will be true. So this is always true. So P and not P is a contradiction and P or not P is a tautology. And the third one is not of not P is simply P. Which of the following is a tautology? So we'll start with option number A, and it is P and P implies Q. Implies Q. So A implies B is not A or B. So I'll write P N, and this is not P or Q implies Q. So here I'll use distributive law. So I'll write P N not P or P N Q implies Q. Now what is P N not P? P N not P is false, and false or P is simply P. So I can write it as P and Q implies Q. Now again, I can write not P and Q or Q. So this is not P or not Q or Q. So I can write not P, and disjunction is associative. So I can write or not Q or Q, and not Q or Q is simply true. So this is not P or true. And if it is not P or true, then it is simply true. So that means option number A itself is a tautology. Now another question is, we need to find negation of this statement, which is, if I become a teacher, then I'll open a school. So we need to find negation of this conditional statement, A implies B. So we know that A implies B is equivalent to not A or B. So which is equivalent to not of not A and then and not B. So it is simply A and not B. So what is A? A is I will become a teacher, and then we have this conjunction. So that means we'll have this and not B. Not B is I will not open a school. So negation of this conditional statement will be I will become a teacher and I will not open a school. So I will become a teacher and I will not open a school. That's your option number D. Another thing that we'll also study in mathematical reasoning is dual of a statement. So basically two statements, S1 and S2. So they are said to be dual of each other if one can be obtained from other simply by replacing AND with OR and OR with AND, true with false and false with true. So when we do that, we say these two statements, they are dual of each other. Now say for example, S1, not A and B is equivalent to not A or not B. Now suppose I have to write dual of the statement, then dual of the statement will be, so I'll write not A, I'll replace AND with OR, so not A or B, AND is equivalent to not A, and here I'll replace OR with AND, not A and not B. So statement 2 is dual of first statement.